She's had high cholesterol for 3 years, but whatever. Don't be afraid to sit up front. It's going to be great. Don't be afraid to sit up front. It's going to be great.
One of our own student composers here at the University of Oklahoma, Laura Beck. Ed Scheich, who created that wonderful arrangement, the National Anthem. Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, as usual, we draw our repertoire for concerts such as this from a variety of sources. Of course, we have original works for bassoon ensemble, that's true, but many of them are transcriptions, are arrangements. And on tonight's program, they're arranged by some pretty well-known, high-level people. The Bach Passacaglia Gesturm is arranged by Donald Hunsberger, famous for his work at the Eastman Wind Ensemble many years ago. The next piece, Overture to Titus or Clemente da Tito, an opera by Mozart, was arranged by a man named Phil Wood. And Mr. Wood was very active in the mid-Missouri area about 20 years ago with one of the earlier versions of the bassoon ensembles. I think they had one of the better names, not quite as good as ours, but they were known as the Boone County Bassoon Band. You gotta love that alliteration. Anyway, he cranked out lots of great arrangements. We got our hands on this one, and this is our first performance of this overture to the opera, Titus.
Thank you.
next piece deserves a bit of an introduction. Composer Sir Peter Maxwell Davies, known as Max to those who knew him well, was a prominent British composer and is responsible for some truly exhilarating, exploratory, as well as difficult works. They were tonally advanced. They were intentionally grating on the ear. But this next piece, Farewell to Stromness, originally composed for solo piano, is one of the most simple pieces you can ever imagine. And that's the beauty of it. It's so straightforward. It's instantly accessible and memorable. And there's an interesting story that goes along with the piece. Max lived on the Orkney Islands off the north coast of Scotland near the small town of Stromness. He lived there from 1971 to his death just last year. This piece was written in the late 70s as a protest work against a proposed uranium mine, which was to fuel a nuclear power plant. Once the islanders of Orkney understood the ramifications of solution mining, they and their Orkney Islands Council opposed the initiative unilaterally. There are theories about how simple this walking baseline is in the opening, symbolizing perhaps the beginning of a doleful residence leaving houses after a supposed contamination. This opening, whether it depicts doleful islanders or not, is really the simplest thing the composer ever wrote, and easily the most lasting of his works. In fact, Prince Charles and Camilla even had played at their wedding in 2005. Max himself recognizes this and is quoted as saying, "My little piano piece, Farewell to Stromness, has almost become a folk tune. People say, I like that piece, and they don't know who wrote it. It gets played an awful lot at funerals these days, and that's very usual for a so-called serious composer to write a piece that people like so much they don't even care who wrote the piece." This is a setting from the original piano version for bassoon quartet, very skillfully arranged by Fraser Jackson. Mr. Jackson is the contrabassoonist of the Toronto Symphony, and we have adapted this quartet version for our Sooner Bassoon Ensemble of 10.
Thank you.
my favorite parts of the show. I relax a little bit. So we're going to break the Sooner Bassooners down into smaller ensembles. And as they're getting set up, this first trio, bassoonists represent the bassoon section of the Wind Symphony. Of course, all our large ensembles are being featured at some point during the weekend. Perhaps you can enjoy their concert later on, the orchestra, Symphony Band next Monday. So this is Nick Lingle and Jared Shea and Brady Shea. And I ask Jared to introduce us.
So today we'll be playing Il Vecchio Castello from Picture of the Exhibition. The composer is Modest Mussorgsky. The piece in English is The Old Castle. And the picture that is depicted by this music is of an old Italian castle with a troubadour singing a song.
As is the next piece, and we have here the orchestra section, Matt B., Matthew Thomas, and Dan. piece. We're clearly into the lighthearted section of this evening's performance. Well, this goes back to my predecessor and very good friend, Carl Rath, who taught here for 31 years, founded the Sooner Bassooners, and remains a good friend of ours. And every once in a while, he sends me a new arrangement and says, try it out with this year's group. So we're happy to deliver that tonight. And I think we even have a little choreography up our sleeves. Priceless Steinway triangle. Concerto, all behind a wonderful boogie-woogie beat. And this was commissioned by the bassoon section of the Oregon Symphony Orchestra, and otherwise known as Bassoon Brothers. So here is The Gang of Wolves by Peter Schiller.
Thank you.
time of year where, of course, we enjoy reflecting on what all great, wonderful things have occurred over the last couple of semesters. We're just 2 weeks away from finals and graduation, and so many people that have helped us along the way. We've hosted 4 guest artists this year in the bassoon studio. One really famous contrabassoon player was here last fall. We had a well-known reed-making guru. Yes, they exist. They're out there. He visited a couple of weeks ago. And a couple of others. And so many in the group have participated and been very successful, placing and being recognized in solo competitions here in Riverfarter, who was seen recently. So I just couldn't be prouder of their work, their commitment, their dedication. And it brings me to a point where I want to recognize one person in particular. This was a young man. It was my first recruit, first person I brought to the University of Oklahoma. And Matthew, all right, Matt Sedibor. Matt has done every single thing I've asked him to do. He's really set a high standard, winning virtually every competition he entered. And we just couldn't be prouder of him. 10 days ago, he delivered a first-rate senior recital. About a week earlier, he was on this very stage, right about there, as winner of the University of Oklahoma Concerto Competition. He delivered a first-rate rendition of the Weber Andante in Hungarian Rondo, one of our stalwart pieces in the repertoire. And he's done it with so much grace, so much class, and we don't lose him immediately. He's going to be student teaching in the fall, but it's remain a part of Sooner and Sooners. I might add that we have a wonderful trip ahead of us to Chicago. Some of you know about that. And Matt will be part of that, of course. And so it caused me to think a little deeper, and that I inherited a wonderful studio and wonderful traditions. And there have been other concerto competition winners. And we did some research and discovered, at least over the last 36 years, we've chronicled that period of time, there have been 6. And it just seemed to make sense to maybe document that in some small way with a plaque. And so Matt's name is on this plaque, number 6. High achievement. I might also add that Matt was the only instrumentalist in the undergraduate division to be selected for the concerto competition. So it was even more spectacular. And so tomorrow, he doesn't know this yet, but Matt's lesson is on Thursdays at 10:30. Yeah, 10:30. Matt's going to be responsible for hanging that on the wall for the bassoon studio. Inspire all the rest to do this evening. And as an individual token of our appreciation and respect for all Matt has done, a little individual award. Sound of Music, my favorite things. I think it's the best tune from the show. And another really great arrangement. And if I'm not mistaken, I think it was Matthew Levine that brought this to my attention about a year ago. So he was online and checking out great bassoon music. And he said, you got to check these guys out. It was the OESP Bassoon Quartet, OESP, from Sao Paulo, Brazil. So I tracked down the music. We listened to that YouTube recording about 300 times. And we're ready to present it tonight. This is my favorite thing.
Thank you.
this piece definitely needs an introduction. Ice Cream Truck 2. And by Amber Ferenz. Heard this piece first time last June in North Carolina, and I thought, what fun. And how can we expand on this? Well, first I have to go to what the composer intends this to be. So I'm going to read her comments. Ice Cream Truck 2 came about while I was awaiting the results of some very scary medical tests. I figure I'd rather laugh than cry. And since I also really like to make other people laugh with my compositions, the time was ripe for another D-arrangement. So there is a wonderful tradition of humor in bassoon ensemble music. I think you've heard a good sampling of that tonight. And it's one of the things I enjoy most about being a bassoonist. It's my very great pleasure to add to our literature in this way. You're going to hear a combination of tunes you may have heard from an ice cream truck, some opera, some popular music, some folk songs, and a whole lot of silliness in this piece. And I hope you enjoy it as much as we do. Don't feel like you have to sit still and very serious for a concert, because this is a very playful, fun, childlike piece.
Thank you.
much for such a wonderful audience and good sports along the way. And I want to cordially invite you to a get-together in the Gothic Hall. We have a reception plan, and I know just as soon as they put their bassoons in cases, they'll be out there to sign autographs or whatever.
Do you want me to? Okay.